Everybody, so this is What If Deku, and I'm probably am going to push this What If all the way to Season 6. But, yeah, this is What If Deku was experimented on. Now, I've seen some other YouTubers do this, but I wanted to switch in a little bit of, like, make Deku a little bit evil. Like, kind of like Superman, but he doesn't have, you know, the moral code of Superman. Like, he just doesn't care about bystanders. He doesn't care about anything. He only cares about the fame and the government and pretty much lawsuits and all that other stuff. But he doesn't care about what happens in the field. He only cares about what's the outcome. So he doesn't really care about anything. So Deku will be having a little bit of, you know, a more of a vendetta of anger towards people that he doesn't even know, but yeah. So in this universe, Deku's mother had a child, but Deku's mother had a child way younger. So Deku's mother gave away Deku. Deku was in an orphanage, but Deku got adopted by a couple of men in black. The people that gave up Deku to that people in black, they just thought they were a gay couple, but they were a group of men trying to get a test subject for a new moral drug or quirk-enhancing drug they're doing. They found out Deku was quirkless, but they still wanted to try out a test that was, a rumor on the streets. So pretty much, it's this new, drug going around in the city to town. Pretty much, it can enhance quirks, in some cases, give people extra quirks. Sorry, guys. So pretty much Deku walks off. Deku pretty much gets experimented on, and Deku was very strong. So Deku, when he was in the orphanage, he was actually a baby. And the drug pretty much works more safely on undeveloped genes. So they used it on Deku when he was about 1 year old to make the bee let him get stronger. So they tried it on him. And first Deku developed some type of invulnerability. Deku was bulletproof, and also Deku was acid-proof. Deku also had was impervious to smoke attacks, like sleeping gas, or pretty much, cancer, or anything. Deku also aged super slow, like a year could be 1,000 years for his body. So, a year can be a day to Deku's body. So, Deku ages incredibly, slow. Pretty much, they use a booster of that drug to make Deku grow up a little bit faster. Then, that booster stopped when Deku was about 16. Through those years, Deku developed pretty much all the powers of Superman. All the powers of a Kryptonian. So, Deku got laser vision, superhuman strength, incredible strength. Deku got flight and also invulnerability. And Deku also got like X-ray vision, super hearing, and also he got. Sorry, guys. So Deku, pretty much. So after this whole entire incident, Deku did get cruel and actually really aggressive to the scientists that were raising him, and Deku pretty much was raised without a dad or a mother or anybody to see as a father figure or a mother figure. So Deku grew up aggressive, impatient. One day Deku escaped the hospital, but he didn't escape like getting out there without anybody noticing. Deku killed every last person in the undercover base they were pretty much raising Deku. He blasted all of them with his laser vision, cutting them in half. He broke necks. He obliterated people with one punch. Deku just killed everybody and left the site and left the lab. After that whole situation, Deku put on an outfit and pretty much lived on the run. Deku mostly lived Deku could sleep while he was flying, so Deku mostly lived in the clouds at sometimes. So Deku one day found out that it was kind of an exam or something to make him a hero. And Deku did learn about it on the internet, because they did get Deku internet when he was growing up, about heroes pretty much getting a bunch of fame, money, and glory. So Deku decided to be a hero. And of course, Deku said it would be easy. And with his powers, it would mostly be easy for Deku. So Deku went to the entrance exam and totally passed it. I'm not even going to say how he passed it. You know, you already know how Deku's going to pass it. He literally has all the powers of Superman. So of course he passed it. Deku did still save Ochaku, but pretty much Deku didn't have any remorse for Ochaku. He just saved her to get a little extra credit. So after that, Deku went back in the clouds, and Deku, after a few days, the marked day, Deku already knew he got in, because come on, he destroyed half of the whole entire city. So Deku went to UA the next day, and pretty much busted through the gates. They didn't really bust through him, he just flew down past the gates. Everybody was stepped back and said, wow, this kid can fly? Deku got back up and walked towards the school. So Deku went to class 1A, and after that, Deku was complimented by everybody, including Ida, but Deku didn't really care. So Deku sat back down and pretty much looked up a couple minutes after that and saw Ochaku pretty much, apologizing, actually thanking Deku. Deku put on a fake smile and said, well, you're welcome. And it was like a really convincing smile. Like, Deku looked exactly like Superman's caring smile. But on the inside, Deku didn't give a shit. So Deku pretty much just said, cool. And she walked off. So after that, Momo walked up to Deku and was about to say something to him. But Uzawa walked in class and said, sit down, and explained to the class that they're doing quirk assessments. They go outside and Deku's told to throw the ball first. Deku throws the ball out of the atmosphere with not even a single sweat being dropped. Everybody's shocked that he can throw that far. And Bakugo gets a little bit pissed that this guy is that strong. For the long jump, Deku just flies over him. For the race, Deku flies past everybody. Deku pretty much goes for the grip test strength. Deku completely destroys it. So after that, Deku is first place, and Bakugo walks up to Deku and says, you think you're all tough and stuff? I'm gonna show you, and throws an explosion at Deku. Deku dodges it, grabs Bakugo's arm, and squeezes it until it snaps. Yeah, Azawa tries to pretty much minimize damage and pretty much try to wrap up Deku. But Deku grabs the bandages and pulls Azawa near him and kicks him in his chest. Azawa gets knocked out cold. Everybody looks at Deku and says, moans to himself that he's freaking strong to take out a pro hero like that. Deku threw the bandages out of his hand and pretty much flew up into the air. And pretty much the principal expelled Deku because he was incredibly strong and he needed him in our school district. So pretty much after that, Deku was still a lot of UA, but everybody in class 1A actually thought Deku was a threat. They didn't really go near Deku. So after that, Deku went back to school the next day, and I'm gonna leave it off here. See you guys later. And Azawa did get, like, well, a little bad side on Deku. But Azawa did, break it to himself that Deku was going to be a great hero one day. Because he was so, he could take me out. But Azawa was kind of suspicious because Deku, the quirk he had didn't, work on Deku. Because Deku's quirk was an enhancing drug quirk, experimenting on it. And it wasn't really, a quirk at all. It was more or less an experiment. So, Deku, no quirk raising bullet or pretty much Quark could take down Deku. And even if, and pretty much Quark Raising Bullet can't even hurt Deku because his skin's invulnerable. So Deku pretty much went to school the next day, and I'm gonna leave it off here. See you guys later. Bye.